excited off on another trip. First adventure I've had since I did the Cameron Corner trip back in April. This weekend I'm heading out with my brothers. We're going to north of Grafton in between Kyogle and Tabulum. No, not between Kyogle and Tabulum. Between Kyogle and Tenterfield. We will be staying near Tabulum at some point. But the purpose of this journey is to go up and check out a couple of national parks, namely the Richmond Rivers National Park, and there's another one just above that. A couple of days cruising around, checking out the sights, having a few beers and hanging out with my brothers. Should be good, looking forward to it. Weather doesn't look that crash off today. It's raining here as I'm sort of driving along north of Kempsey. Hopefully the weather won't continue all the way up the coast, but I guess we'll find out.
You fucking dickwad!
Still a weird feeling coming across the new bridge, even though it's a couple of years old now. Just never quite get used to it, having driven that old bridge there for so long. Always weird coming back into town and taking this road. Day, but hopefully the camera's picking it up. It's a wet start to my camping adventure, but here I am in Grafton. Lovely place, my favourite place in the world. And this is why, this time of the year, look at it, magic. Jacaranda time. Of course, Grafton, famous for the Jacaranda Festival. Lots of memories as a young fella, a young kid living in this town. Lots of memories. Jacaranda time, awesome. If you like flowers, trees, nature, or just the colour purple, I love this town, October through to about December. Go under the train line.
Brothers, and I've just called into Copmanhurst, and for those Cold Chisel fans, you'll recognise a line from their song Merry-Go-Round where they talk about the Copmanhurst Rodeo. Well, this field here, right there, this field all the way around here, this is the ground they're talking about. The Copmanhurst Rodeo. I don't think they're very good bulls in there, but this is the paddock. It's where it all unfolded, all the action. Caught in a bit of lunch, but before I do, a little bit rainy. Oops, since I last spoke to people, I've done a few little mods to my car. I've put a fridge in, as you can see, obviously that's the fridge there, and a little set of drawers there, and a little water tank there, which is handy. And I got adventurous, and I thought I'd do my own little dual battery system. So what I have done, if I can get this seat open enough, is because I don't know what the hell I'm doing, I went and bought this little pack from 4WD Supercenter. I know a lot of people don't like this stuff, but that's quite handy. It's all cabled up, ready to roll. You just got to plug your batteries in. So I ran the cabling through, it's the second battery there. It works really well. The fridge runs off that, and I'm about to plug a few accessories into it to charge up for the rest of the journey. It's also got solar input, which is good. Not going to need it today, judging by the weather, but hopefully tomorrow it'll be nice. So I'm going to have a quick feed and then get on the road. Talk to you later. I'll talk to myself later.
I'm gonna step out to the town.
it to camp. My brother over there playing with diesel, trying to get the fire going. It's a bit wet. It's working. And then we found this little patch of stuff down by the river, and there's my setup. I'm ready to roll for the night. Brother's Triton there. Got a bad little setup down here. The river over yonder, good swimming hole. No doubt you'll be able to fish in there. There's fire going out, Jagger. So I'm here with my niece, Felicity, who you might remember from the Uwinga videos. Now, she just doesn't shut up. Anyway, we're at Yates Crossing, which is another crossing on the Clarence River.
Do you want to go in there?
Not really. Do you want to go for a swim?
Do you?
Because I'll throw you in.
I'll push you in. Then you'll go tumble and die.
Clarence River, eh? Bit of flow in it today, which is good to see. Duck. Or don't then. It's turned out to be a lovely day after all that rain earlier this morning. Go away, Flick. Should be like this all day tomorrow, hopefully.
Late George Wolno worked on High Street and lived on Manors. 52 years he sat in his veranda and made his saddles. And if you had questions about sheep or flowers or dogs, you just ask the saddler. He lived without sin. They're building a library for him. Time is a traveler, Tenderfield saddler, turn your head. Ride again, Jackaroo, think I see kangaroo.
Just outside Tabalum along this cutting, a road I haven't been on before. It's the Clarence River down there, beautiful part of the world. The Rocky River, just before it flows in the Clarence, the mouth of it's just down there. Ignore my brother swearing in the background. I'm out camping this weekend. My brother Justin's gone home, he's only for one night, but with me brother Chris, his Mrs. Melissa, their daughter Kaisha, her fella Jake, my nephew Casey, my niece Felicity, as everyone knows. Beautiful little part of the world here. It's So as I was saying, the mouth of this river is just about there as it flows into the Clarence.
The son of George Wolno went off and got married and had a war baby. Something was wrong, and it's easier to drink than go crazy. And if there were questions about why the end was so sad, well, George had no answers about why a son ever has need of a gun. Time is a traveler, tender field saddler, turning head. Ride again, Jackaroo, think I see kangaroo up ahead.
Oh, Mel, you ruined the shot.
I know, I'll move out of it, that's how I realised.
I'm just shit stirring. The Light Horse Monument, Tabulum.
Son of George has been all around the world and lives no special place. Changed his last name and he married a girl with an interesting face. He'd almost forgotten them both, because in the life that he leads, there's nowhere for George.
So I'm at this place called Paddy's Flat, which is a point of interest because of these things called tank traps. They used to go stretch across the river here. The reason being, they were a defence in World War II in case the Japanese invaded, designed to stop tanks from moving south. You can camp here on the Clarence River as well. It's really pretty. I do love it in the Clarence Valley. It's one of my favourite places in the world. Obviously, when you spend, you know, the first 18 years of your life there, you have a natural calling, I guess, to keep coming back. And it's a part of the world I didn't explore a lot as a kid, but I'm certainly exploring a lot of it now as an adult. I've come to another crossing on the Clarence River. This one here is called Paddy's Flat. The tank traps that you've probably just seen on my video, or about to see, whichever way I put it together. Way up past Tabulum. I'll give you a look, see. Maybe how nice is that water look? Beautiful patch of area. Patch of the world here. Crystal clear water. You drink that stuff straight out of the river if you want to do. Gotta go down in a minute and dunk my feet. So I can see it up there, looking at us.
Yeah, you can see us coming down. You can see the rest of them coming down.
That was the plan.
His library, or the sun with his gun to belong. Except in this song, time is a traveler. Ten of your saddle, turn your head. Ride again, Jackaroo. Think I see kangaroo up ahead. Oh, time is a middle.
So we're out near Tulum. There's this cool mountain over there called the Beehive. It sticks out like dog's balls in the surrounding area. On the Summerland Way, between Woodenbong and Kyogle. Never been to this part of the world before, and I've come across Mount Lindsay, so I'll show you that. Beautiful mountain. Mountain sticks out like dog's balls. There's heaps of these types of mountains around here. Beautiful. Devastated by bushfires last year. Looks like it's starting to slowly recover. And then I believe, if you look over there, see that mountain range over there? Top of that is the Queensland border, I think. New South Wales on this side, Queensland on the other.
Fly away, cockatoo, down on the ground, emu up ahead. Time is a tale teller, tenterfield saddle, a tiny head. Ride again, jackaroo, think I see kangaroo.
All the way up this hill to the Toonooba National Park entrance, and it's closed. It's probably still recovering from the bushfires a couple of years ago, a couple of summers ago. But we're not allowed in this way, so you have to try a different way. Nice though, that big staghorn up there. You can see it there. Right there, nice. There's the tuna. Boys just turn around the background.
Tough it out like an old brigalow. From the back of the Channel Country across the western plains, the roads are straight and dusty and the folks are much the same. Roots run strong and deep out here in a hat town, and we'll carry on down through the years in a hat town. We'll not be thought.
A bit rainy today, so I didn't get to get the drone out and get a video of the campsite here at the Toonooba Dam. I'll just whip this around. And the Gronk's up there. Brother's Land Cruiser and his daughter's bloke's Hilux. A bit of open space here. Got toilets and stuff, it's pretty good. And you've got the dam just down there. Boat access. It's pretty good. $10 a night per adult. Yeah. We're on the Toonooba Dam wall. So this water supply looks after Kyogle and places like that, surrounding districts. So we camped up and around that corner last night. As far as dams go, it's quite a nice one, scenic.
Downs. There's a pub and a store and not much more. You're living in an old hat town. Stuck out in the heat haze, a half mile 60 zone. Just a ragtag bunch of buildings made of wood and tin and stone. There's a swag of stories, most of them are true.